Very good evening to all of you. So we are going to start today's webinar. So this is a series of webinars which are being hosted by Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology for all the new aspirants to Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology. Specifically, this particular webinar is going to talk about Computer Science and Engineering Department, what we are going to offer you once you are in our campus. Now, this slide set will take half an hour at the maximum, and then we'll be able to take your questions. Now, I request everyone whosoever is putting their questions in the chat box, rather than doing that, kindly put your question in the QA section. So they are going to be handled by the moderator, not the chat questions. And secondly, the participants who are raising their hands, kindly let the presentation get finished. The reason being, most of your queries will be already answered within the presentation. But if still there are some queries, then you can raise the hand at the end of the webinar and we'll be able to allow you to speak and ask your question. Also, we are live on YouTube. So YouTube channel of Thapar University official channel, we are live there also. If the people are not able to attend this webinar, they can go to our YouTube channel and watch it there also. So now let's start. So if you look at this particular slide, if you see, if you say that how to make 2 + 2 = 4, so it will be a great thing to do. But I would like that if you can do 2 + 2 × 5, if you are able to do this, then definitely you are in computer science engineering program. The reason being, whatever you can think of, let's say if I am a mechanical engineer or a civil engineer, if I am able to realize my dream, so I would require years and years of hard labor in order to come out to some level. But if I am a software engineer, if I am a software developer, if I am a computer engineer, then in order to fulfill my dream, I need only 24 hours. So I spend 24 hours in front of my computer, and if I know the coding standards, if I know how to code well, I'll be able to finish this task within. And that, those are the names to be rendered with. You know Facebook, how it came to the life. You know how the Google went off and how the Google is faring up in our lives. The similar, there are n number of examples, and these people may be dropouts from the colleges, or they have done some kind of an extension to their know-how in computing, and now they are entrepreneurs, they are running their own businesses, they are actually giving the opportunities to n number of people around the globe. And that's where the computer science and engineering come in play. So now, if you look at this particular slide, particular presentation. So if you look at the top, we have something which is called theoretical computer science, where we basically cover the computable theory, Turing machine. This was the first machine which was there. After that, personal computers, and we went into the high-end computing machines. Then we have subject called data structures, one of the most favorite subjects for anybody who is studying computer science or computer engineering per se, any computing branch. So data structure is one subject which need to be honed, the skills in that need to be honed. Similarly, we have another subject called software engineering. We have computer networks, and then we have database management system. So these are the 4 or 5 very critical subjects, and they are being offered at Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology in any of the flavors of their computing programs, be it computer engineering, be it computer science engineering, or it is computer science and business system. So all of these are being offered in all the branches of computer science which we are offer here. The reason being, these are the only subjects on which you need to concentrate much more than anything else. Now, having said this, I'm not saying that we deny the fact that machine learning. So we did n number of changes in our curricula and brought in AI and machine learning in the core. So computer science engineering people, they usually learn machine learning and artificial intelligence in the core. Then finally, they graduate to some kind of an application. We have augmented reality, we have virtual reality, We talk about big data. There is a subject on that. We have natural language processing. We have subjects on hacking. We have subjects on secure coding. We have subjects on computer vision, image processing. So all whatever is being showcased on this particular slide to you, this is what is the core part which is being covered in all our three variants of computer science engineering. Now the department name is computer science engineering, but the courses which we offered, the first course which we started in 1992, so this was a computer engineering program. Now you know the start of computer engineering, basically there were three mother branches initially. One was electrical, civil and mechanical. So electrical was basically a shoot off from a basic sciences physics subject, and then it became electrical engineering. From the electrical engineering, there is an offshoot which we call as computer engineering. So most of the old IITs and most of the foreign land universities, like if you talk about the university in the US, they offer a course which is called BE in computer engineering. So having that base, we started this program in 1992. And then in 2018, we have a off-campus, which is at Dera Bassi. In Dera Bassi, we started computer science and engineering program in 2018 and brought the same program back here in Patiala in 2019. So we have two programs running, one at Dera Bassi and another is at Patiala. And this is computer science engineering. Then in 2019, we also started a program with the help of Tata Consultancy Services. And the program name is Computer Science and Business Systems. Now, when I say in the collaboration with TCS, TCS is basically doing a part of BIT. Like they have proposed the curricula, which is AICTE approved curricula. And also they are kind of training the trainer. So if somebody has inclination into business system, apart from his computing know-how and his inclination into the computing system, this is the course to go with. This course we started in 2019. Then we had two postgraduate courses. One is Master's in Software Engineering, we started in 2002, and Computer Science and Engineering program, which we started in 2005. And also, as our faculty strength is, because it's the biggest department in Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology, almost 50, more than 50% of the student strength and faculty is in computer science and engineering. Now, having said that, we have at this point of time 62 faculty members who are doctorate in our program, and this is one of the biggest department as per the doctoral people available in India. So we have research program, which is a full-fledged doctoral program. And at this point of time, we have 134 registered candidates. And during this admission, we offered 30 seats to more PhD candidates. So in overall, if you see, there are near about 160 people who are getting their PhD degrees. So when I'm saying that to a BE student, it may not mean anything for him. But if you look at the core strength of our faculty and the kind of a program and kind of the offerings we have, this will actually build your confidence so that the kind of faculty, kind of infrastructure, kind of the research which is being done at Thapar Institute of Engineering Technology, specifically computer science engineering program, which really boost your career prospects. Now, computer engineering program, as I told, it started in 1992. Now, this is NBA accredited. This is National Board of Accreditation, which is a local accreditation body in India. And then also we have Abbott accreditation, which is the American Board for Engineering Council. They also accredited the program. In 2018, our program got 6 years of Abbott accreditation with no weakness and no concern raised by Abbott. Now, as far as the faculty strength goes, we have 7 professors in the department. We have 13 associate professors, 64 assistant professors, and total at this point of time, 84 faculty members in the department. And these are the thrust areas of deep study. I haven't mentioned thrust area of research. Reason being, all these areas which are being showcased here, they also attract our UG programs to contribute. So UG program students can also contribute to these centers of excellence, which we are trying to build at our computer science engineering department. One is cyber physical system and security. Another one is language technologies and machine learning. fuzzy-based systems, cloud and software system engineering program, pervasive and adaptive system, wireless network and mobile computing. Now, out of this, if you look at the fourth one, which is cloud and software system engineering, this is headed by my colleague, Professor Inderveer Channa. She is a panelist today. So any question related, she is also happened to be Dean of Student Affairs. So if any question happens to be related with the activities which are being done at Thapar Institute by students or by any kind of query for hostel and all, or even if you want to ask something about research in cloud and software system, she is the apt person to reply your queries. Now, this is our, it may not be good for a BE kind of a student to follow this, but this slide has definitely some meaning in it. I'll tell you the reason. At this point of time, if you look, we have 1,140 seats in different flavors of our computing. Now comes the point, all of these 1,140 students, are they aspirants to be in companies? Or there are few who want to go in a higher study and do research? Or there are few who want to be entrepreneurs? So in order to build that particular ecosystem, so we have done each and everything what could have been done in our curricula. So I am going to talk a bit about that curricula later in the slide. But if you look at this particular slide, it tells you about that our graph of citations are that how many people refer to the particular paper which was published by our faculty members. So this graph is consistently growing. So this will tell you that how much research intensive stuff is being built into our program. And because we have now university and now new policy which has come from Government of India, so this is that each and every deemed university of institute of excellence, they would be called a university. Then when we say university, this is not just a dissemination of knowledge, rather than we need to create knowledge, and knowledge creation can only happen by virtue of research. And that's what we are putting forward here. Now, these are the high impact journal factors, impact factor journals in which our faculty members have published their articles. And this is how, if you talk about Times Higher Education ranking, which is worldwide renowned ranking, in that computer science and engineering program at Thapar Institute have been rated in 3001 to 400 category. And this is very prestigious for us to showcase this. The reason being, in India, there are only, beside the top five IITs, old IITs, one of the greatest thing which could happen to our department is that we are in the top 10 in country at this point of time offering computer science engineering program. This is in the public domain. Anybody who wishes to explore further, they can go to the World University ranking and find out where our computer science program is. Then we have, in order to cater to the aspirations of students to do research, to get into the companies, we end up in having lots of many MOUs, and these are live MOUs. These are not some files which are sitting on my table. Rather, these are which are very, very active MOUs. So we have MOU with Infosys, we have MOU with TCS, where they actually help us, our research scholars, to do research in very niche areas of computing. Then we have NVIDIA, where GPU computing, and we also have DGX station for high computational tasks. Then we have University of Florida. If you want to go for your 6-month internship into this, we have a MOU with that also. We have MOU with Apple University program. We have MOU with IBM, Unix, Cisco. We have with Zebia for DevOps and continuous development. We have with Future First for financial derivatives. We have having a MOU with Samsung R&D and also Virginia Tech USA. So this is the latest one with Virginia Tech USA. We are building on to it. So by this time, we could have end up in having a very solid MOU with VT. But because of this pandemic, it's it got somewhat delayed, but down the line, within another 2-3 months, when the situation is conducive, we'll be able to get these thing, this thing also in place. Now, these are the various industries which visit our campus for placements over CS students, from Google to Cisco to Microsoft to Future First to Texas Instruments, you name it, we have it. So almost 350 companies, major companies, product as well as service companies, they visit Thapar for recruiting over computer science students. And this is our international collaboration. So you can do 2+2 program, 2 years here and 2 years in Trinity College Dublin. And then also you have University of Queensland program, where we have 2+2 program, where is undergraduate degree from University of Queensland. You can enter into 3+2 program, where the undergraduate degree will be offered by TIT and postgraduate degree by University of Queensland. Also, we have 3.5 and 2. That means there is a one slot full semester available, which is called apprenticeship, where you will be able to do some work in the industry. This is how we have tweened our program, and these are the two international collaborations for program specific. Other collaborations are in academic research and all. But from a program specific perspective, if you want to avail any of these, those opportunities are also available. Now, before going to the slides where we are going to discuss the difference between computer science and computer engineering and computer science and business system, because if I look at the chat and your QA questions, almost more than 75% questions are on what is the difference between COE, what is the difference between CSE and CSBS, and what could be my first preference. So I'm going to just stop this share and show you some of our students and where they are working, because that is kind of a highlight which will actually spark something within you as a student to Thapar, that you aspire to be in those kind of companies. Just let me share another screen with you, where I have just in the today morning, I spent a lot of time in order to fetch this information for you. And it's also live available on my LinkedIn. So if you look at this, this is Pragya Mehta. Indarveer, my slide is visible. Okay. So she is Pragya Mehta, one of our students, very bright student. She is working in Microsoft in Greater Seattle area. Rachita Jain, she is also software engineering, working at Facebook. She did BTech from BE from our computer engineering program. And she did later on join Carnegie Mellon University. And now she's working in Facebook. So we are proud of these alumni. And there are lots of many. I've just showcased few which I myself have taught, and I know them face by face. So that's what I am showing you here. Nupur Shukla, she is Microsoft software engineer. Sheena Mittal, she is working in Apple as product manager. Farin Aluwalia, she is working at Salesforce. Priyam Sirohi, she is working in California. She did her master's in Stony Brook University. Shruti Gupta, she is working as senior software engineer at Microsoft. Ujjwal Goyal, he's working at GS Associates. Chirag Shahi, he's working in Advantest as a software engineer. He's also in US, work in the Texas state. Then we have Nitika Garg. She's in California, based at California. She did her master's from Arizona State University. Then we have Anirudh Kaul. He's also pretty famous name. He is head of AI at Aira. So he just spent 1 year with us, and I still remember this guy who came to one day to me and said, "Sir, my laptop has burned." I was just astonished how your laptop can burn. And this guy was doing a huge number crunching task, and 24/7 for 3 days his laptop was running. And he actually burnt his chip. So that's how he came to us. But he just spent 1 year. But within that 1 year, this was kind of a spark he created amongst his peers. Now, at this point of time, he is working in San Francisco Bay Area. And he's also did his master's from Carnegie Mellon University. And then we have Pulkit Khurana. He's working at Google. Lavi Makkar, she's working at Microsoft. Lokesh at Facebook. Niharika at Microsoft. Kalhan at Amazon Web Services. So you name it, we have it. And this Vedant Maini, another of my favorite student, he did his master from Cornell. And I know how many people can dream of Cornell and Stanford. And these are the students which we are proud of. And this guy has done wonderfully wonder tasks in YouTube. And he's working with YouTube at this point of time. Then we have Pavika Singhal. She's working with AWS, Purvanshi. She is working as an AI scientist in Amazon. And then Mridul, he's working in Facebook. Prateek Shokin, he's working. So I have hundreds of examples. Now let's come to the current batch. You are just seniors which have gone from just graduated this year. So we have, just let me scroll. Prabjot Singh, he is in Cisco. He's a consulting engineer in Cisco. Then we have Nikhil Jain. He's working in Microsoft. These are 2020 past graduates. Prakhar Gupta, he is at Synopsys. Manraj Chokolia, he is in Microsoft. Divya Kumari, she's also in Cisco. Upsahaj Makkad, he is working in Bloomberg. And also in the pipeline, he has written Creative Computing Society. This is one of the favorite societies in Thapar. Whenever you enter, this is one society the people would love to go to. And it happens from the founding days, Inderveer is president of this society. So you would love to join these kind of societies. At this point of time, we have 52 societies, very active societies on campus. Then there is a Prateek Chikara. He's working as housing.com as data scientist. Then we have Arushi Mishra. She's working at Apple. So these are the students in 2020 batch only, which got these accolades. And all of these students have done wonderfully well in their academics. Now let's go back to the slide, and I have only 2-3 more slides to let you know what we are at this point of time. I'm going to just share those. Just a second. Okay. Are you able to see this?
It's visible.
Just give me a second. Was it visible in the view?
Yeah, previously, of course.
Okay. Yeah. Now let's talk about what many of you have questioned, that what is difference between various variants of computing at Thapar. So one, if you see here, this is computer engineering scheme, and on top of it I have just changed and highlighted some differences from computer engineering and computer science. As I already told you, computer engineering is our base program. We started in 1992. Computer science and engineering is our new program. We started in 2018 in Derabasi and 2019 in our Patiala campus. Now, if you see, the first year is common. There is no change in the first year of both the program. When you come to the second year, engineering material is only covered in COE. This is computer engineering. So we need to give touch of engineering subjects to our students. So computer engineering and engineering design, these are the two things which are in curricula of computer engineering. Whereas COA, which is computer organization and architecture, which is in the CSE program. But if you see here COA, the same COA is appearing in our computer engineering course also. So it's not that we are leaving anything behind in both the courses, but only difference is there are some hardware subjects and some design subjects which are only part of computer engineering. And I'll just highlight those. For example, manufacturing processes, measurement science and techniques, which is kind of a required subject if you wish to work in IoT. You need to know what kind of a sensor is being used for what. So this is a basic course for that. Then we have engineering design project 2, where we are going to create a buggy. This is a team project. And then we have microprocessor based design in the sixth semester and innovation and entrepreneurship in the sixth semester. Also, we have embedded system design in our seventh semester. So these are the subjects which are not available in computer science, rather they are only in computer engineering. Having said that, then what is there in the computer science? Apart from the base, you have computer network, you have database, you have data structure, you have algorithms, you have artificial intelligence, you have networks, all are there in computer science. Plus you have the course which is quantum computing. This is not available in computer engineering. This is only in computer science engineering. And also we have another subject which is cognitive computing. So this is also not available in computer engineering. This is in CSE. So only these two subjects are which are the differentiators from CSE and COE. But there are many design and hardware oriented have to say to a layman. So basically COE is a superset of CSE. So whatever is covered in the CSE, everything is covered in COE also. Okay. So whatever is there in the COE, definitely everything will drill down to our computer science and business system as well as our computer science and engineering program. Then when we move from here, let's go to the next slide. So we are offering some elective focus in the niche areas, where you people will be able to get a degree, plus it will be mentioned that in which elective focus area you have graduated. So here, one is if you are interested in how supercomputers work, how parallel computers work, how the GP computing is empowering the computing world into doing wonderful tasks, then you should opt for high performance computing. And this choice is being given to you at the end of your second year. Then you have to choose. And based on your choices, we create a merit list. And based on the merit list, we allocate these elective focuses to the students. Then we have computer animation and gaming. Then we have data science. Then we have information and cybersecurity. We have DevOps and continuous delivery with the collaboration with Zebia. This is the industry partner here, Zebia. And then we have financial derivatives with the help of Future First. So these two baskets are offered with the collaboration with industry, Future First and Zebia. So these are the seven baskets which are available to computer science engineering students, as well as these baskets are available to computer engineering students to choose. And apart from core computing, they can graduate in any of these elective focus areas. Now let's come to computer science and business systems. So this is computer science and business system curricula. If you look in here, so we are going to talk about discrete maths. We are going to talk about business communication. We are going to talk about fundamentals of economics. We are going to talk about business communication and value system, apart from the computing subjects, which are core. Now, what are those? We have data structures and algorithms. We have linear algebra. We have statistic, probability and calculus. We have fundamentals of computer science. So these are the core computing in the first year, apart from the business subjects also. Now, if you go to the second year, we have in the second year software engineering core, we have object-oriented programming core, we have computer organization core, we have formal language and automata theory as core. But if you look at this subject here, design thinking, this is exclusively for CSBS. Marketing research, this is exclusively for CSBS scheme. Rest, everything is available in our computer engineering program as well as our computer science engineering program. Let's go to the next slide. So we have business strategies, we have fundamentals of management, we have business communication and value science, we have financial and cost accounting, we have business communication and value science four. So these are the courses which are inclined towards the business system. That's why the name is computer science and business system. So these are the three variants which are available at Thapar for you to consume. So now it's your choice for your know-how. Today is the last day to apply. That is the 31st July till 11:59 PM. You can apply to any of these courses. But in order to change your based on whatever we have discussed today, somebody may like to change his choice. That is available till tomorrow 11:59 p.m. So till 11:59 tomorrow p.m., you can log in into your account again and change the preferences if you wish to do so. And this is the just snippets of few of our new modern infrastructure. If you look at this particular picture, this is your computer science and engineering department. This is your lecture hall complex. And this is your new library. So this is G plus 5, ground floor plus 5 floors building. And we have 35 undergraduate labs. And we have 5 research labs. And we have 4 doctoral student lab and multiple other things. Data center is housed in our building. We have our network center housed in our building. So all those things are available in this particular building. And this is a brand new stuff which have been built in 2018. So 2018, we acquired this building. 2017 late, we acquired this building and shifted completely in 2018. So this is where we wish you people to join us. And at this point of time, I'm going to end my slideshow and we'll take up questions. Whatever questions you have, kindly go ahead and ask. So meanwhile, the moderator joins in. So I'll just allow few people to speak. You can raise your hand if anybody has any question. So we'll make you speak and ask your question. Okay, so let's start with Pranjal Dheer. Yes, Pranjal, you can make yourself unmute and speak, please. Yes, Pranjal. Okay, let's move to Karthik. Yeah, Karthik.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Karthik Bansal, please.
Sir, is there any difference between Patiala campus and Dera Bassi campus for CSE?
No, as such, there is no difference, beta. Only thing is that 2 years you are going to study in Dera Bassi and in year 3 and 4 you will come back here. See,
in Dera Bassi, you teach or another teacher come for teaching?
No, we have a same faculty. The people from here are only, they have been sent to Dera Bassi to teach because of their vicinity of their home. So they live around Chandigarh. So they opted for this, but the recruitment is in the main campus. Head of the department is the same.
Sir, and there is any scholarship available for
Thapa? Yeah, scholarships are available, but that actually what has happened because of this pandemic and JEE Main not happening in near future, which we can foresee. So we have changed our admission criteria to +2 admissions. So we are revamping our scholarship because previously it was mostly attuned to JEE Main exams and how the people are scored there. But now we are attuning it and within another week you will see on our website fee waiver, and then we have 45 which are only tuition fee waiver, and then we have more than 200 scholarship which fall under the merit scholarships. And then also for the people who are not able to pay the fee, we have merit cum mean scholarship. So in total we actually give near about 7 crore of rupees at scholarships to the people. So that is kind of scholarships we have. But only thing is, you need to wait for another week in order to see the new scholarship policy which will be published.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. So can I allow Yash Shukla? Mr. Yash Shukla, please.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, if I have not opted for computer in my 10+2 studies, can I opt for a CSE program?
Yes, there is no bar. If you haven't done it, actually we'll look at PCM score where C can be replaced by any of the vocational subjects in order to create your merit.
Okay, thank you. But I want to ask, will I be able to cope with that?
Yes. We are going to start from very scratch, beta. So okay. it's not like if somebody has done computer science or somebody has done Java or C++ in their plus 2 or 10th standard. Now government of India has come up with a new policy ki starting from the 6th standard onwards, you need to have coding skills. Okay. So, but once you come into a Thapar, so we are going to start from very scratch. No worries on that part.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Indarveer, you want to say something on this?
I fully support this, and there is no need to refrain because you haven't done anything in programming before. There is no reason to refrain yourself.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Yash. So I am allowing Anushka. Anushka, you can please ask your question. Anushka Goel.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Bit louder, please, beta.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
I ain't really able to understand the meaning between computer engineering and computer science and the... just a second. Computer science and engineering. Like, what's the basic difference? Like, is computer engineering about the hardware and the other ones about coding and software?
I don't know whether your connection was some trouble with your connection, because I explained very elaborately that what is the difference. But still, because you have asked the question again.
There's a problem with the network. Yeah. Sorry, okay, sir.
Let me answer it again for you. See, yeah. There is no difference from the recruiter standpoint of view. Recruiter will come and he will judge you on the coding skills and your aptitude and your quant knowledge and your logical ability. So once you are through with this, then you are in an interview, and then you will be asked about what kind of elective focus you have chosen, what is your area of interest. So if you do computer engineering, or you do computer science engineering, or you do computer science and business system, all are covering the basic core aspects of computing. So there is no such difference. But if you ask me the curricular difference, yes, there are two subjects of hardware which are there in computer engineering, and two design projects which are part of computer engineering, which are not part of computer science engineering.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Ishani Sharma.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Sir, I have to ask you two things.
Yeah.
Sir, just consider that during first round of counseling, I am allotted a seat and I want to upgrade that seat. I have to pay the money and make the seat floating. If by chance I got the upgraded seat in the last round of counseling, or if by bad luck I don't get an upgraded seat, then the seat which I made floating will remain mine or would be allotted to someone else?
See, at the end of last round, see, whenever the classes will start, whatever branch you have been allotted at the last counseling, that will automatically get freeze for you. So it is your seat. Nobody can challenge.
Okay, sir. So the second thing is that as many boards have declared the results few days back, and many students have failed re-evaluation, and the result is awaited, as the board officials are saying that the result would be out in mid-August. So, sir, just imagine that I got my result on 10th or 12th of August. Then would I be able to upload my mark sheet again before ongoing round of counseling? Would it be beneficial for me for upgradation?
That is possible, Bete. But in that case, what will happen? Whatever the vacant seats are available, then only you will be considered. The reason being, at this point of time, see, at Thapar, 93% of the people who apply are from CBSE and ICSE board.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so there are very few which are in that category where the boards might not have done their homework and result is not out.
Okay, sir.
In those cases, we will not be able to prepare the merit list. So it can happen that still we can consider that, but only that consideration will be if the seat is vacant.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Om Sharma. Yes, Sharma.
Yeah, I'm a parent. I wanted to ask, like, since CSE and CSBS are new branches, would it be deemed equal as COE if students want to pursue higher education outside India?
Yes, madam, they are perfectly fine. There's no issue in pursuing higher education.
Okay, like it was written, accreditations are there for COE, but
No, madam, the reason is, see, we cannot apply for accreditation unless until the program has lived for 3 years.
Okay.
So as I told you, in Dera Bassi it started in 2018, in Patiala it started in 2019. Mm-hmm. But by the time these students will graduate in 2023, definitely these program will have that accreditation.
All right, thank you so much.
Okay. Yeah, Deepto, you take on the moderator job, please.
Right, sir. So we are taking on some participants' questions, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So let's get Atul on board. Atul Goyal.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Yeah.
Myself, Atul Goyal's mother. Sir, on your website, it is shown that there are total 2,395 students, but yeah, the total placements are only 1,100. As a Thapad is such a renowned institution, why so less placements?
No, I'll tell you, madam. 2,235 is now. 4 year back, it was not that. 4 year back, it was only 1,200 students.
Okay.
Now, what has happened? Past 5 years, we are on a journey of contemporization. We actually hooked ourselves to one of the best universities in the world and revamped our curricula, revamped our infrastructure, and also got approvals from AICT for increase in the seats.
Okay.
So now you, if you look from today onwards till 2023, then the amount of the students will be 8,000 on campus.
Okay.
Right, okay,
thank you. And sir, one more question. That, can I have some idea about the mess charges?
Inderveer, mess charges, can you give some idea?
We have two modes of messes here. One is being run by a professional company, Sodexo, and then there is another mode through which we run, that is cooperative messes, which are being run in few of the hostels. And depending, if you are in a cooperative mess, your kid is in a cooperative mess, depending upon how many expenses we had, the bills would be calculated, and on the basis of that, the diet is calculated. So you can, just for an approximation, it can be 100 rupees per day, just an approximation as of now, I'm telling. It can escalate also.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay.
Let's get Harshit.
Harshit Raizada.
Yeah. Go ahead, sir. Hello?
Yes, Harshit.
Okay, let's go with the next one. Naman Taneja. Yes. Namanji, please go ahead. Okay. There seems to be... So I'll just take up some questions from the open sections. But I'm not sure if they have been answered before or not. So
you go ahead. If it is that so, we'll let you know. Please,
sure.
Go ahead.
Sir, is cloud and software engineering come under the same specialization?
Cloud and software engineering. So the no. These are two different parts. So cloud computing is covered in our HPC, that's high performance computing basket, whereas software engineering is in the DevOps and continuous development. And yeah, having said that, software engineering is also core to computers. So computing, software engineering, whether it is computer engineering or science or business system, this is being taught.
Right, sir. Sir, can I get into cybersecurity force of the Indian government by taking CS?
Yes, why not? So if you qualify, if you choose your elective focus as information and cybersecurity, definitely you have very bright chances, provided you follow the rules and regulations set up by the elective focus coordinator.
Right, sir. Sir, I want to know, what is the main difference between BE, CSE and BTech in CSE?
See, my dear, I think in the admissions webinars also these kind of questions have come up. See, BE is Bachelor of Engineering, whereas BTech is Bachelor of Technology. When we talk about technology, we are basically focusing on how to apply technology to get the solutions rather than designing something. Okay, whereas engineering is designing and engineering a product. So it is more product orientation in engineering than in technology. Basically, it started that BTech in IT, which is information technology. Whereas most of the famous programs in famous universities will have BE in computer engineering, BE in computer science and engineering. So having said that, for a layman or for many of us, almost 90% of us, there will be no difference in BTech and BE, just a simple nomenclature difference. But for if you want to really know the difference, I have already told you.
Right, sir. Sir, another query is, Dera Bassi and Patiala campus both offer CSE. Which campus is better with respect to placements at the final year?
The placements always happen at the main campus. So when you spend 2 years in Dera Bassi, you are going to come back to your parent campus, which is Patiala campus. So our placement cell, everything is in Patiala campus. So they will be able to help you. And it is same for Dera Bassi campus students and Patiala campus students. There is no distinction.
Right, sir. Sir, if we select the 2+2 scheme, so will the admissions be direct into those international university, like without any examination, and would there be scholarship attached as well?
See, it's very different when you get admitted into international engineering program. International engineering program is direct admission provided at the end of 2 years, you have 8.5 CGPA. So if you have less than 8 CGPA, you will not be able to go to the foreign land. So they don't allow the students which are below merit to enter into their stream. So in that case, what will happen? Let's say you have, I'm just giving a very hypothetical example just so that the people can understand. Let's say you take computer engineering twin program with TCD. That's a Trinity College Dublin. So you get admission into this. Because the cost is high, so very few people apply there. Let's say you take it and you have 75% marks in plus two. Even then it is possible to take admission because less number of students are there. But now if you don't score 8 CGPA at the end of second year, then you will fall back in Thapar and you will continue with the same level of merit seat. It may be chemical engineering, it may be civil engineering. So you will not be in the computer engineering anymore. So it is not kind of a backdoor entry. Many people may think that let's take into IEP and after 2 years we can drop and we still be in a major branch. That is not possible. Okay. So choose it wisely. If you are really want to go to international engineering program, then only you put your foot forward.
Right, sir. Sir, I want to become an entrepreneur and want to be a CEO of a company. So what program would be profitable for me, CSBS or CSE?
See, in that case, CSBS actually doesn't offer anything at this point of time. The reason being, the last semester of CSBS program is internship. Whereas in CSE and COE program, the last semester can be a startup semester. You can incubate your idea, you can ideate, and you can be in our entrepreneur development cell, and you can spend whole 6 months here in order to nurture your startup. So in that case, you can become entrepreneur. So full one semester is given. If you are not interested in that, you have semester which you can dedicate to your research. If you are not interested in that, you have the same semester available to you to do internship in the company. So there are three variants available in the computer engineering and computer science and engineering program to nurture your dreams.
Right, sir. So do we have anything on the scholarship?
We already spoken about it. I have already made it clear to everyone.
Right, sir. Sir, what is the ratio of boys and girls in computer science?
See, boys and girls ratio across the engineering programs in all over India, it is 30% of girls students and 70% of the boys students. The same kind of ratio is here. But in computer science, we see more girls, maybe in 40 to 45% girls.
Right, sir. Sir, is there a really big difference between CSPS and other computer branches?
No, as such, there is no difference. Also a four-year degree program. Only thing is it also offers you business subjects along with computing subjects. As such, there is no other difference.
Right, sir. Sir, what is the major difference between Patiala and Dera Bassi campus? Is the faculty different? Is the course going to be different?
No, I have already answered, but still, because you are asked the question again. So there is no difference. The same faculty which is recruited at Patiala campus is being sent to Dera Bassi to teach. There is no difference in the infrastructure. Like internet connectivity, it is being given from Thapar campus itself. The same kind of internet connectivity, same kind of library resources, same faculty, same dean, same head, same director. So there is no difference here.
Right, sir. Sir, if due to some reason I missed the first counseling session, even though I was eligible for the same, can I take part in the further sessions and can I change my branch in the next counseling?
No, if you miss the first counseling and you don't pay the fee, you will not be considered for the next counseling.
Right, sir. So we'll allow some attendee to ask a question. Rashi Goyal, please go ahead, ma'am.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening, Jay.
Good evening, Rashi.
Sir, I wanted to ask that in the 2+2 program, in the third year in Dera Bassi, will we be totally shifted to Patiala campus and will be given hostel facility also, or we have to do up down?
No. Total shift beta. You will be housed in Patiala campus.
And sir, all the projects, the research work, the lab work, they will all happen at Patiala campus only.
Yes. Whatever facility is for CSC, Patiala, same thing is. I told you, there's no difference.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir, is there any effect with the new education policy on the course of BTech on our batch?
No. See, it is a draft policy which has just come up. It will be ratified and finally it will take some time in order to be in place. And once in place, then it will be in 5+3+3+4 mode. That means 5 years of primary in your own languages and then go and graduate. So it's a long thought of document, but it will take some time in order to get into our regular circular kind of a stuff.
Right, sir. But Mr. Bansal, who wants to ask a question.
Yeah. Please go ahead, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, Vishesh.
Yeah, sir, I am mother of Vishesh. I have a query that if I have opted for 2+2 program, like 2 years in Thapar and 2 years in Trinity College, with passing of time, if I change my mind and I wanted to continue in Thapar, is it possible?
It is possible, but madam, as I told you, if the merit of the student is not at par with the merit of our computer students, he will not get to continue with the computer. So he will fall down the merit to whatever branch his merit is in.
Okay, and do you have any...
For example, let's say you take admission in IEP program with 80% of marks in PCM, but then you decided not to go to Trinity due to any reason. In that case, 80% marks with 80% mark, whatever branch you would have got in Thapar as per the merit, you will be continuing with that only, but not the computer science engineering or computer engineering branch.
Okay, so one more query, like in the current selection process, do you have separate criteria for the international program and for the thorough Thapar program? Like your cutoffs will depend differently for both programs?
Yes, madam, it is different because I told you international engineering program is costly and very few people apply there. So there, that's why you can even get admission into our computing with a lower merit.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's get Sandeep Kumar wants to ask a question.
Yeah, good evening, sir. Just a related question, even though you have spoken about a scholarship, in last couple of webinars, we are talking about the policy is going to be there within next week or 10 days or so. But finally, you are saying it will be there within a week. So my two questions, will it be available before first counseling, that is 5th of August, that is one. And second, I mean, will the scholarship would be a part of need to apply for the scholarship based on the criteria? Thank you.
Sir, there are two things here. Number one, you know the condition in which we are living in the world today. So it was very difficult to convene meetings over the net and decide on some matters which cannot be done over the internet. Okay. So that's why it took some time in order to formalize the policy. So definitely, and most probably, I think before 5th of August, that policy will be up on the website. Okay. And second question you asked about, I just went off my mind.
Yeah,
I'll answer that.
Okay.
Sir, it is the scholarship is not part of your offer letter. Once the students are in, then we ask them to apply, and then on the basis of that merit, whatever they had in the test, the scholarships are offered.
Okay, thank you.
Right. Sir, if I want to join the international program later when I already have an admission in COE or CSE, can I do it in second year?
See, the thing is like this. This international program has very minimal seats. It's only having 30, 35 seats available. So if the seats are available and if the international engineering program coordinator and the coordinator at Trinity College Dublin, they sync, they may allow. But at this point of time, I am not in a position to let you anything more than this.
Right, sir. Sir, after 2 years in the Derabasi campus, do we need to maintain any CGPA or all students will be transferred?
All students will be transferred.
Right, sir.
But having said that, I'll appreciate if you maintain a very good CG.
Right, definitely. So we've got Parminder Singh. Yeah.
Good evening, sir.
Yes,
is your new CSC approved by UGC?
We are not able to get this.
Good evening, sir. I want to ask one question.
Anji.
Is science, which is new course, is approved by UGC?
The UGC does not approve courses. UGC is for a total mandate of universities. AICT approves the courses, and AICT has approved CSC course.
It is approved now.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Right, sir. Let's move on to the next candidate, Shubham Verma.
Dittu, we'll finish at 6:30. Yeah.
Okay.
Hello.
Sir.
Hello.
Yeah. Shubham.
Sir, I'm from Maharashtra, Mumbai. Sir, I wanted to know that as I'm a state board student from Maharashtra, I have 80% in my PCM. So, sir, how the normalization process will take place? Like, if a Delhi student had got more percentage, but like CBSE student had got more percentage, but some papers have not been taken by them. So, whether there will be any normalization process or not?
See, my dear friend, all the core course, all the core subject were evaluated and the exams were given. PCM sabhi ka hua hai. Only some vocational subjects and later on some subjects were not evaluated. And their examination were not held, but all other were held. And as I told you, 93% of our admitters are from CBSE and ICSE. So there is no question of any kind of normalization happening.
Okay, sir. Or chemistry ke pe computer science ko use kar sakte PCM mein?
Kar sakte hain ji, kar sakte.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, if our classes go online, how will I be able to gain practical knowledge?
The practical knowledge in computer science in today's world, if somebody says I need to go face and face and attend, I don't think that is justifiable. But having said that, if there are hardware courses where you need to do something with the hands, by that time we pray to the God that everything will be okay. But still, if it is not possible, there are virtual lab setups which are available, by virtue of which you will be able to feel the components by using virtual reality, augmented reality, haptic or HMDs, head mounted displays, all those technologies are available. Don't worry.
Right, sir. So we've got Keshav Garg who wants to ask a question.
Good evening, sir and ma'am. I want to know about cloud computing and its scope in future.
Cloud computing has a great scope, my dear. The reason being, no more we have machines which are housed in the data centers of local servers. Data centers are big, big, big data centers at various places across geography. Now, in order to access that, how will do this? So I need to go to the cloud and access it. So yes. Cloud computing has a great future.
Thank you, sir.
Right. Let's go with the next candidate. Maybe this is Jay, Jay Mall.
Jay Mall.
Nice name. Yeah, Jay, please go ahead.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, can you hear?
Bit louder, yeah. Thoda sa unche bolenge to sunega proper.
Sir, I want to ask that can I get a scholarship on the basis of JEE Main 2020 January exam?
No.
Sir, still we are waiting for the directive of the government also. Maybe at the end, few of the scholarships would be awarded on that basis. But as of now, we are not planning. We'll wait. If the government declares that yes, JEE Mains would be considered as January JEE Mains only, maybe in that case. But still, we have to wait for that.
So put your fingers like this.
Okay, let's move on to the next one. Rishabh Gupta.
Yes.
Yeah.
I want to ask two questions. First question is that in your application form, there are three options mandatory: physics, chemistry, maths, and we can add additional subject, technical vocational subject. So I have added additional subject as IP, informatics practices. But at the end, in the application summary, IP is not being displayed.
See, don't worry. Actually, we have list of vocational subjects which can replace your chemistry. Okay, you want
so
to...
The highest marks will be applicable, no?
Yes, max will calculate the max and allot the merit accordingly. Don't worry.
And sir, another question is that if we pay the fees at the end of the counseling, and as you know, JEE Mains are scheduled on September, and if we are getting a good college in JEE Mains, then what will be the refund policy?
But I am very sorry to say, if you are talking to a Thapar faculty and saying good college somewhere else, I don't understand this. This is the best of the things which you can have. But nevertheless, it's your choice. If you want to go to any other college, it's your choice. Having said that, we have complete refund policy available on our website, admissions.thapar.edu. Kindly read it and we'll follow that religiously.
Okay, sir. And one thing, sir, the total fees for 1 year is 1,82,000 for computer science?
Total fees for 1 year is 1,84,000 and 23,000 admission. That means 13,000 admission and 10,000 is your security. So the total fees is 2,07,000 something.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, so let's go with the next candidate, maybe Ritesh Chauhan. Yeah, Ritesh Chauhan. Okay, Ritesh.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, G.
Sir, I want to ask one question.
Yeah, Ritesh.
I think
sir, when will be the counseling will start in Thapar University?
Sir, last date of applying is today. Counseling is online, so automatically counseling will be there. On the 5th of August, you will get the first merit list on our website.
But sir, if we don't apply in JEE Mains 2020, so it is compulsory for CS admission in Thapar University?
I am not getting it.
Sir, if I don't get JEE Main 2020.
No, don't get it. You haven't given, you aapne January ka exam nahi diya.
Yes, sir.
So koi problem nahi. On plus two basis, you can get admission, na?
Sir, on the basis of PCM?
Yes, yes, my dear.
Okay. Sir, total aggregate percentage nahi dekha jayega, sir.
टोटल एग्रीगेट ही देखा जाएगा पीसीएम और क्या है यार पीसीएम सिर्फ पीसीएम जो जो सी है उसको आप रिप्लेस कर सकते हो विद एनी वोकेशनल सब्जेक्ट
ओके सर
टेक्निकल वोकेशनल सब्जेक्ट Okay, sir. Not music or Hindi or something or Sanskrit kind of subject.
Okay, sir.
Right. Thank you. Next question is by Harshul. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Yeah, Harshul.
Sir, my question is, sir, what is the scope of cybersecurity in the upcoming future?
Oh, great scope, yeah. Whatever happens today happens online. Like now we are doing an online webinar with you. If somebody infiltrates into this or somebody actually improvises and change my voice and say that whosoever is attending this seminar got admitted in Thapar, it is a cyber attack. So how to avoid those kind of things happening? It's possible, and this can be done with the help of cybersecurity and great future.
So which is more possible, which is the best scope for cybersecurity or information data analytics?
Both are very different stories. Yeah, you can apply data scientist, data analytics in your cybersecurity. So if you want to churn in data and find out who did what on Facebook or who did what in a particular social media, so you will require data mining, data science kind of a know-how in order to use it. So all of these things are interweaved together. So it's not that if I am a data scientist, I cannot work in cybersecurity. If I am a cybersecurity, I must not work in data science.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, are classes going online? How much time on an average will a student spend on attending the lectures?
See, it is total as you would have done face to face in Thapar. The classes go on from 8 to 6. Obviously, there are breaks in between, and now there is a shorter version of the lecture. Previously, we used to have 1 hour. Now it is 45 minutes. The reason being, you cannot continuously sit and speak in front of this digital media. So we have reduced that, but obviously the classes will be from 8 morning till 6 evening. So these class, most of the theory classes in the first half, and then we have practical classes.
Meri gaadi kahan hai?
Okay. Sir, what kind of internship opportunities are available in the last semester of computer science?
Oh, that's very good question. Almost 90% of the people who apply for their internship semester rather than research semester or startup semester, they go to very, very good companies. And they are being paid internship. So at this point of time, the highest paid internship is 95,000 rupees and it goes till 30,000. So the minimum is 25,000 to 30,000 and max is 95,000 to even 1,20,000 the previous year students have got in order to work for a company as a 6-month intern. And once they are doing a job as an intern for 6 months, almost 90% of them get consumed in that particular company itself. And that is a great USP we have. It's a 6 months full-time internship in industry.
Right, sir. So we've got Anubhav who wants to ask a question. Anubhav, please go ahead, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, Anubhav.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, what is the fees of hostel for 1 year?
See, at this point of time for this semester, we are not offering. But still, Inderveer madam, because she is Dean of Student Affairs, she'll be able to better tell you what kind of expenses will be in range. Some kind of range you can tell, Inderveer.
Okay, sir.
We have actually 14 hostels. 9 are for boys and 5 are for girls. And then there are hostels which are fully air-conditioned also. As far as first-year students are concerned, you would be getting a shared accommodation. And all the room rates are displayed on the website for 3-seater, what is the rate, for 2-seater, what is the rate. And depending upon in which hostel you get the accommodation, you would be charged. Right. So you can just visit the website. And then you can also visit the student corner. There you will be knowing about how many hostels are there, pictures are available. You can visit that gallery. You can know about the facilities that are available in each of the hostels. So those things are available. You can have a look on the page. And the link is at students' corner.
Okay.
Thank you. Sir, how good is the regional diversity in the campus, or is it very North India focused? Is it possible to get some insight as a virtual tours into lab hostels facilities?
See, lab hostel facilities, virtual tour is okay, but from the regional diversity, dean student would be better equipped to answer.
We are already planning some virtual tours, and most probably in near future, you would be having those kinds of virtual tours as well as videos available on the website. And if you talk of diversity, we have students on board from all over India. You have students from Maharashtra, we have students from Gujarat, we have students from Kanpur. So if you look at it, even from South, so we have all sorts of students, because 50% of the seats of Thapa University are reserved for other states. And only 50% students are from Punjab. And when we say other state, even Chandigarh is other state for.
And also we have foreign nationals, the people from Southeast Asia, we have people from other countries who are on campus. So regional, or you can say it's a global diverse campus. Though the students from the outside world are less, but still we are aspiring that at least that should also grow.
Right, sir. Sir, what is the difference between data science and big data analytics?
See, data science, whatever you do in data science is related to how you talk to a data, whether it's a small data or a big data or what kind of a data, it doesn't matter. Only there will be change in the algorithmic change would be there, or how you deal with the data, what kind of a database are being used. So if you have structured data, you will talk about RDBMS. If you have non-structured data, you will talk about non-SQL data. So as such, there is you cannot make differentiation, and you cannot say they are apart. So big data is how the data is coming, with what velocity, with what veracity, with what kind of a value, variation. There are so many V's in big data.
Right, sir. So we've got Amrit Singh Gill who wants to ask a question. Go ahead, Amrit.
Good evening to all of you.
Good evening.
This is regarding the admission. The process is being done at such a time that the JEE main results have not yet come out. And in case a student gets admission on the basis of JEE main in some other college or university, and in case he wants to shift, the time period which is given for the refund of the money is very short. I would request that for the benefit of the kids, because the amount is also quite high. It is around 2 lakhs plus. So I think it should be increased the time for the refund.
See, frankly, Mr. Amrit, this is out of our jurisdiction. What I can request you, can send an email to registrar@thapa.edu with this concern. So let's see if they accede to this request.
Okay, thanks for the advice.
Thank you, sir. Sir, can you elaborate on the international program with University of Queensland, Australia, as you've only mentioned TCD?
No, I have mentioned both. University of Queensland program is also in 2+2 mode. You do 2 years here and do 2 years in University of Queensland. And then you will graduate with a bachelor degree from University of Queensland. Or you can do 3+2. So 3 years in Thapa, 2 years in Queensland. So we'll take the credit back, offer our undergraduate degree. They will consider the credits. They will give you the post-graduation degree.
Right. So we've got Nikhil Gandhi who wants to ask a question. Go ahead.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, G.
Yeah, good evening.
Sir, I know it's very difficult to answer this question for you because many of the application would have been coming, but I am very tense about it. So can you answer that if I have scored 96% in CBSE PCM aggregate, can I get CSE or COE at Patiala campus?
See, frankly speaking, this question is out of scope for us for at least till 5th of August. The reason is merit list is getting prepared, and today by 11:59 PM, there will be many applications. You know, our server is getting lots of hit at this point of time. So even if I say it is possible, not possible, that will not make any sense. So please, wait for another 4 or 5 days till the merit list comes. But having said that, I think 96 is very good score.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, let's get another attendee, Anshu Sharma.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, I want to ask that in Dera Bassi campus, if I got CSE, then my 2 years will be in Dera Bassi and 2 years in Patiala. So, will I get my degree in the name of Dera Bassi campus or in the Patiala campus?
So, there is no mention of any Dera Bassi campus on the degree. It is Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology, Patiala. See, that is our extended campus. It is not an individual entity which is in Dera Bassi. It is part and parcel of Thapar University.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir, could you further inform about the fundamental criteria of the course of education and classes at Thapar to get into Trinity in Dublin?
See, Trinity in Dublin, if you want to go, you have to upfront apply for international engineering program. There's nothing what we'll do and get you to Trinity. So you apply there, and within your first 2 years, you score a minimum CGP of 8. You are good to go to Trinity.
Right, sir.
Provided the seats are available and you are on merit. The reason being, as I told you, there are only 30 seats.
Right, sir. So we've got Anjali Marwaha who wants to ask a question. Anjali, please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. I am Anjali's father.
Yes.
Although we reside outside India, but we have applied in resident category. Now the question is, can we separately apply in NRE category also? Because why we did so is because Anjali got 96.8% in PCM, and we were hoping that we will get in resident category only. So assuming there will be some saving in fees, we did so. So can we apply, can we make two applications, one in NRE category and one separately that we have already done?
Sir, she did her plus two from where?
She has done from UAE.
Okay, from UAE.
Yeah.
So it's a very peculiar question, and I think only the Dean of Academic Affairs would be able to. What I request you, because it's still time left. So what you can do, you can just send an email to doaa@thapar.edu.
Okay. Though we have already applied in resident category.
I understood your question, yes. but it is not in my purview, sir.
Fine. Another question, sir. Suppose she ends up getting the third stream of her choice. Obviously, the first will be computer science and all that. And later, the better choices like computer engineering seat is vacant. Maybe for some reasons, some aspirant of other college has left and there is a seat vacant. So whether she will get upgraded or somebody else will get that seat?
Oh, if she falls in merit, she will be upgraded till her first choice.
Okay, till her first choice. Secondly, sir, the scholarship will be applicable to NRA students also?
So if she is in merit, there is no bar, sir. If she, okay. She falls in the merit, she will get it.
Yes. Any other question you want to ask?
What is the fee structure for University of Queensland?
Beta, that your father should be worried about. Why you are? You concentrate on the studies, yeah.
Thanks for the advice, sir.
Thank you.
I'll just advise you in case, because the time is short, if you want, you please apply in that NRI category as well, because the domicile can, because the plus two is from UAE.
And sir, just if we wish to visit Patiala to see our child, is there any facility in the campus for parents to stay for a day or two?
Yeah, we have guest house, sir, and we are nearby. There are very good hotels, so don't worry, okay. Sir. Patiala is a beautiful city, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thanks. Thank you, sir.
So, last question, Dipto. Okay. Yeah.
Sir, what is DevOps and what is the scope of DevOps?
See, what was happening till date, the development and operation teams were different. and there was a misunderstanding between the teams, miscommunication between the teams. Now, what has happened down the line from last one decade, this DevOps kind of a thing is coming up. The reason being the development and operation team, if they sit together, the productivity and the quality of the product, software product, which is coming out of the company will be definitely better than what it is being done individually. So that is what is meant by DevOps and operation. That means development as well as the operations. So once you come here, we have more elaboration. It will take another 1 hour for me to explain the differences and what DevOps basically offers you. And we have tied up with a company called Zebia. It's a Netherlands-based company. And they have a very good program. So you, once you are in Thapar, you can choose this as your elective focus to see what can be done. Meanwhile, we have another two questions to answer. We have launched a poll. So I request you people to fill this poll in order to better frame our next seminars. Okay. So I request everybody, whosoever is online, kindly fill this poll for us.
Right, sir. So we'll just take another two. So Harpreet Singh, please go ahead, sir. Okay. Harkirat Singh.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, Harpreet.
Thank you, sir. I have got all my queries solved in the webinar.
Thank you.
Sir, I want to ask, what kind of research work is done in computer science and engineering?
See, there are lots of many projects which are there. If I name a few, we are working on electrical vehicles, energy efficiency of there. We are working on tuberculosis detection, producing a sensor devices for that. We are working in the area of natural language processing. We are working in the area of cloud computing, how the resource provisioning will happen. So we have research in computer vision, where we are actually building a system which will tell doctors how to wash hand after they do surgery. So all those things are whatever you think of in today's era of computing. Almost, because I told you there are 62 people in my department who are doctorates. So they are working in diverse areas of computing. So there is no dearth of, if you are willing to learn, we can offer you anything, whatever is possible in computing.
Okay, thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, Harpreet. Harkirat, the last candidate.
Good evening to all of you. This is Harkirat's father, Colonel MP Singh. I read in the prospectus that there are certain seats reserved for central government employees. Can you please elaborate on that, how to apply for it?
Sir, central government employees, I don't think there is any mention of that. I'm not aware. I'm very sorry. I'll not be able to answer this query of yours. So what I can request you, if you in the chat, you can write your number. We can have a call back from our admission team. Going on. So I want everybody to fill that poll.
Okay, I think it's really hard to figure out, because then the number starts filling up. Everybody starts writing the chat.
Okay.
So let's just take one more. I think the last one.
Yeah, last one. Please. Yeah.
So let's take Saket Ranjan Jha. Yeah. So,
Saket. Hi. Good evening, sir. Good evening, ma'am. Sir, actually, my question was that, I had always a little bit problem in coding. Like, if we say about HTML or QBasic also, it took really a hard time for me to pass them out. But, sir, I'm really willing to do hard work. And as we know that in this era, like, computer science is on everybody's mind. So would it be a problem for me? Like, what would be the basic requirement for me to take up CSE?
See, there are two major requirements. Anybody who wants to do coding, you need to be very good in your logical aptitude. You must be able to find out a step-by-step solution to any problem, any real-world problem or any kind of problem. Secondly, you need to be very good in combinatorial mathematics. So if you are good at counting numbers and all, counting number theory, and if you are good at applying those procedures in a step-by-step manner, you are a programmer. That's why it is called engineering. You have a engineering built into it. It's not an art which is being, somebody has given you hereditary and you will become programmer. Aisa nahi hai. It's step-by-step procedure. Anybody can learn programming, how to code. Only thing is you have to apply mind logically in order to produce the result.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thanks. Okay. I think that's all the time we have for the webinar, for today's very long webinar. So if you have any more queries, you can actually send us an email at admissions@thapar.edu. And for any more information, you can visit our website. That's www.thapar.edu. In order to apply, you can visit admissions.thapar.edu. Please remember that today is the last day to apply. That is 31st of July, 2020, 11:59 p.m. So I posted the same onto the chat. So to conclude with, I'd like to thank the head of the department, Dr. Maninder Singh, as well as the associative head of the computer science and engineering department, Dr. Inderveet Channa, to give us a very beautiful presentation and giving us a detailed information about computer science program at TIET. On behalf of Thapar, again, I'd like to thank all the attendees for making this particular webinar a beautiful success. We definitely hope to see you or your ward at Thapar. Therefore, please stay safe and have a wonderful evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thanks, Indavi. Thanks, Dipto.
Thank you.